Lord, Yeah. Слава Вреске Зантовецу Богу, аж мне в нижке вам дьяны савденцами, а у на мне
Yeah. seated. Անունով եւ որդով եւ հոգու Սրբ, ամեն։ Սիրելի քույրեր եւ եղբայրներ, dear brothers and sisters in Christ, it's great honor and also pleasure to come once again to Oxford and to celebrate Mass, Armenian Liturgy, in this beautiful chapel, and also to listen the angelic voice of the choir of the Armenian Society of Oxford. Before I start reflecting on the message of, or reflecting on today's message, I would like to thank, first of all, the Dean of the Chapel of Pembroke College, who allow us to celebrate Mass every year, once a year. And I believe if we come often, they will welcome us. And also, I would like to thank Armenian Oxford Society and also Faculty of Armenian Studies, led by Professor Teovan Lind, who is present, who is singing with us today during the liturgy. Oxford Armenian Society and this beautiful choir, and also to all of you, guests of Armenians who have come to listen to Armenian liturgy and follow us. Maybe you don't understand the language that we are singing, but I believe that the spirit is the same, and you enjoy this beautiful liturgy. This is the liturgy of the Armenian Church, and the Armenian Church is one of the ancient Oriental churches. We represent an ancient Christian nation who has identified her history with the cross of Christ. We have suffered, we were persecuted, but also we rose on the third day, and we have created this beautiful culture which belongs to us, but it also is a part of universal, it belongs also to humanity. And today we have come here to celebrate, when especially Armenian Church is celebrating one of the beautiful feasts of Armenian Church, is the feast of St. Sarkis. We have a lot of universal saints, which you have in Greek tradition, in Catholic tradition, but St. Sarkis is unique. It is peculiar to Armenian Church only. It's about 4th century Armenian saints, not Armenian. Tradition says he was Cappadocian, maybe Greek, and who served in different armies of the time, Byzantine, Armenian, and then Persian. And the tradition says that in the 4th century he was converted into Christianity, and while serving in the army of Persian king, he was told to worship pagan gods. He rejected, and because of that he was tortured and he was killed. Not only him, St. Sarkis, who was a warrior, but also his son, whose name was Martyr, and 14 soldiers with him. And this has become a tradition also to call this a day of youth. And St. Sarkis has become patron saint of young people. And usually in the Armenian tradition, in Armenia, there is a huge celebration of this day and blessing of young people. And some people say that this is Armenian Valentine's Day. But apparently the 40 soldiers who were martyred with St. Sarkis, they were young people. This is why we celebrate, and this is example also to young people, their lives, to learn about them. I mean, it's a sad story when someone is paying the highest price for conviction, for faith, but it was our reality, and it is still our reality. Usually I tell, when I speak about saints, St. Sarkis or other saints, They were ordinary people like us. But their action was extraordinary. And also there is huge possibility that each of us, any Christian, can become a saint. And maybe there are saints among us, we don't know. But the lesson that we learned from today's feast and today's liturgy is to know that it is not easy to be a Christian. Christianity is a way of life. As we follow, as we accept that we are Christians and we have to follow this way, and we have to know that it's not easy, it's very difficult way. We read from the Gospel just half an hour ago. And in the Gospel, Jesus Christ says, because of me, you will be betrayed, even you will be imprisoned and you will be tortured. Nowadays, no one will imprison us, no one will torture us, especially in our egalitarian societies. But I believe it is very difficult to follow this way, Christian way of life, which is maybe not fashionable in our days. Maybe it will seem a little bit difficult, but the Christianity is offering a way that is based on love, on mutual respect, and also on trust. When we are trying to build a better society, I think the best book to learn and to follow is the Gospel of Jesus Christ, which is not easy way. But also we know, and we have example, that today, even in our times, many Christians, especially in the Middle East, paid the highest price to be Christian. We know about modern martyrs and many people who are being persecuted because of their faith, because of their Christian faith in Syria, in Iraq, and other countries in the Middle East. So this is an example for us. From one hand, we have Christians who still pay the highest price for their faith. One of the Christian leaders, modern Christian leaders, Pope Francis, when he met with our Catholics 5 years ago, he said that the Armenians have given more martyrs in the beginning of 20th century than the general, all the Christianity in the first 4 centuries of Christianity. But now the number of martyrs are increasing and we have more martyrs. This is a message for us that the faith that we have is not given or granted. We have to achieve, we have to earn also the name to be Christian. We have to follow the way of Christ and we have to also change in our lives. This is the main message of today's, and our St. Sarkis is being celebrated today. He inherited this crown of martyr, paying the highest price, but we know also that we can inherit this crown of sainthood by our lives, living, doing good things, and serving our brothers and sisters, and being just simply a good Christian. Today I would like to once again extend my thankfulness to you for organizing this beautiful event. We will continue now our liturgy, and Armenian Church has Eucharistic hospitality. Those of you who are not member of the Armenian Church, you are most welcome to come and partake in the Holy Communion. And I pray for your community, for our young people, and for the peace in the world. DIOCESE, շնորհի եւ օրհնությունը լինեն ամենքիս հետ այժմ եւ միշտ եւ ավետյանը սարդենից ամեն։ Երբում ես ավարտական ձայն բարբարով բարնալս բերանս մեր քարտալս կեզ երկավորը դարի երկեն եւ ասել։
Thank you. Thank you. Pembroke Chapel, everyone, for a new, in this academic year, a new liturgical event. We've had the Armenian liturgy in Pembroke for several years now, and we are very glad and grateful to Reverend Andrew Teal for allowing us to use the chapel in Pembroke College. As you can see around us, there are several people who form the Oxford University Armenian Choir, and it is a great pleasure for us to sing the Armenian liturgy at least once a year, and we hope a bit more often in the future in this chapel. We are also very grateful for Archbishop Hovakim Manukyan, who is the primate of the Armenian Church in the United Kingdom and Ireland, that he will celebrate the Mass with us and for us today. So without further ado, I would like to welcome you all and hope you will join in with us in celebrating the Armenian liturgy today.
Oh, take Holy Communion, please come forward and take part in the Holy Sacrament. Come all your work for your work for the Lord. Amen.
Neva amenasu gero kutian, or your work for your work for the Lord. Neusa amasuzo, Kosovani Marachi Astuzo, Yersepo Asadatni, Yevarachi Amenaim Sukos, Yevarachi Kohasu, Zamenaim Melezo Korziari. Kanzine Vafur, O, Anide Korzo, Kamai Vakama, Kilukian Devan Kilukian, Neva Astuzo.
As God told you, Shoresse, may God grant you forgiveness.
I have also sinned by the sevenfold transgressions of the deadly sins, by pride and all its forms, envy and all its forms, anger and all its forms, sloth and all its forms, covetousness and all its forms, gluttony and all its forms, and lust and all its forms. I have sinned against God, Mirastuzo.
May God grant you forgiveness.
I have also sinned against all the commandments of God, both prescribed and prohibited, for I have neither performed the prescribed commands, nor abstained from that which is prohibited. I accepted the laws, but was slothful in keeping them. I was invited into the order of Christianity, but was found unworthy of it by my works. Knowing the evil, I willingly followed it, and from good works I purposely kept away. Woe to me, woe to me, woe to me. Which of my misdeeds shall I recount, or which shall I confess? For my sins are innumerable, my iniquities are unspeakable, my pains are unbelievable, and my wounds are incurable. I have sinned against God. Meraz.
May God grant you forgiveness.
Holy Father, I hold you as reconciler and intercessor with the only begotten Son of God, that by the authority given to me, you will release me of the bonds of my sins, I implore you.
Devor mia, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. May God, the love of mankind, have mercy on you and grant you forgiveness of all your sins. And with the priestly authority, and by the divine command, that whatever you lose on earth should be loosed in heaven. I absolve you of all participation in your sins, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And I reinstate you in the sacrament of the Holy Church, that whatever good you do may be counted to you as works of goodness and for the glory of the life to come. Amen.
Thank you. If you